Hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Oblivion. So, in the last episode, we went through Skingrad and did everything there because I'd accidentally started Glarthier's paranoia quest, but I figure since we completed all of that, let's go ahead and just continue on with doing the rest of the cities. I mean, it's not a bad idea to get these quests out of the way. We're gonna have to do them sooner or later. And this way, I won't forget about any miscellaneous quests after we get started with the various guilds and stuff like that. And my voice is sort of a little gone, so excuse me if I'm just going to be like quieter during this episode. I really don't mean to be, but I can't really talk all that loudly. So first things first, we need to find some quests here in Bravil, because this is the city I want to focus on in this episode. Oh my god.
Gil Gondrin, Silver Home on the Water has beds and food. What's your pleasure?
Ladies. No, okay. Well, it's just a mess gold. rumors.
Everyone's talking about the assassination, of course.
No,
here,
I don't.
Take my copy of the new Black Horse Courier. Go ahead, keep it.
Yeah, I was there.
Have you heard about that ghost of the old
there
man
we go.
That looks out into Nibbin Bay each night? They're calling him the Forlorn Watchman. Spooky.
Yeah, the Forlorn Watchman
looks like he may have been a sailor. No one knows where he came from or why he looks so sad.
I don't like talking about the dead like they're some kind of tourist attraction, but that spirit has been making his ghostly journey for years now.
We've learned to just accept that he's there. Every night, short as clockwork, he appears at Bonwatch Camp at 8 on the shore of Nibbin Bay.
He's never harmed anyone, but most people give him a wide berth. You seem curious enough, so I'll be glad to pinpoint where he appears on your map.
And there we go. So we have our first quest here. In fact, Bravil is pretty easy to get all the quests for. Since I believe there's only three, and two out of the three are self-contained within Bravil. Well, sort of. You'll see when we get to one of them. It's not entirely self-contained, but whatever. I think I'm going to quickly go through and invest in every shop. And while I'm doing these quests in the cities, I figure I can
you too.
Go through. Are you also a merchant at this shop, technically? I don't know. You're inside, though. But, I should actually check and see if they have one here. But,
how are you? Brokeel Grove.
I've already forgotten what I was
Goodbye.
Going to say.
Well, what do you want?
You're standing on the chair.
Good day.
Yeah, that's right. Get down from there. Wow, my mind has completely blanked from what I wanted to say. Oh well, let me just move on then. Man, I can't even remember what the shops are here. Oh, right. So there's, while we're doing this. Whoa.
Just kidding. Everything is all perfectly safe. Tested it myself. Ungarian, retired adventurer. You may have heard of me.
No, I just want to invest. Okay, then. Step Farewell. Away slowly. Since we're going through to every town, I figured I may go ahead and give coins to all the beggars.
What do you
or speak to them, at the very least. You're not a beggar. Goodbye. There's two in every city, and if I can find them and do that, it'll be really easy for me to complete that quest. Are you a beggar?
One more coin and...
I think you are.
Thank you.
There we go.
Blessings of Mistara.
Oh, no more shops? I could have sworn there were more here. Are you the same person?
Excuse me, my lord.
Oh, we need to talk to you anyway. So let's go ahead and talk to you.
I'm sorry to impose upon you like this, but I'm in need of assistance, and I don't know what to do. My husband, Alaron, is missing.
Oh, no. Yeah, this is another quest that we've got to do.
It all started when Alaron became foolish and started gambling. He'd visit the arena every week and spend our hard-earned money on bets.
Oh, vices.
I told him to stop, but he didn't listen. He was certain he could win us a fortune and move us somewhere nicer, like the Imperial City. It didn't take long for Alaran to begin losing. He resorted to borrowing money from a usurer to cover his losses and placed new bets.
Oh, no.
As you can imagine, it didn't pay off. He ended up owing around 500 gold.
I could pay that. I'm paying that to every shop.
We could never have that kind of money to pay back the usurer.
You want 500 gold? So, moral of the story, don't get involved with the mob.
Yesterday, the usurer, Curden Grow Dragel, sent for my husband to meet him at the Lonely Suitor Lodge. He hasn't returned since.
Lonely Suitor Lodge sounds really shady. Like the casting couch.
Curden isn't known for his patience. Please, I'm not wealthy. But I'd give anything to see Alaron again.
Well, let's help out. Why not?
You will? Oh, thank you. Please be careful. I don't wish any harm to befall you either.
Well, looks like we're gonna have to find out what happened to her husband as well. Things are getting weird here. Actually, yeah, we're still in the Forlorn Watchmen. Don't know if every mage in there is considered a different, merchant. We'll have to find out. I don't know if mages are considered merchants by this game. Oh, Lonely Cedar Lodge. Here we go. We should be able to find out some, things here.
I'm Brogram Grogalash, your host at the Lonely Suitor Lodge. It may not look like much outside, but that's just the weathered Bravil look.
Well, let's invest. And then go up.
Bye.
Hello, stranger.
You also?
Luciana Galena. I'm Braville's advanced trainer for the light armor discipline.
The whole town's trainer? Okay, then.
I would gladly...
There we go. Invested in you.
Bye.
How are you? What?
Oh, yeah, you're just some dude.
Good day.
With snazzy armor. And you are Ranaline.
Ranaline. I cook at the Lonely Suitor.
Okay, you're not very interesting.
Take care.
See, that's you.
You get me close, and I'll turn your bones to ash.
You've got to stick up your ass.
I have no time for your pathetic attempts at small talk. Now, walk away before I get nasty.
Wow. You are an
asshole.
I have
no time.
I'm just going to keep talking to you.
I have no...
Will he attack us? I wonder.
I have no time.
Yeah, I don't think he'll attack us. What is it? I was trying to get him to fight. Oh, yeah. So that's to do that quest, but let's hold off on that for the moment. Because I want to check the rest of Bravil first. Bravil? Bravil? Some people say it, like, really exaggerated. Oh, nerd root. Well, there we go. There's a nerd root here. There's actually quite a few inside of Bravil. I'm not going to go around and collect them just yet. I might do it when it's later out. House for sale. Could have sworn there was another merchant around here, but... Oh, Archer's Paradox. Here we go. So, a lot of them don't have the signs.
The Archer's Paradox. Because a perfect arrow flies forever, and that's impossible. I'm Daemlin, and I have no perfect arrows.
Interesting.
I would gladly let...
And then we've invested in him. I really hope that I invest in everybody. Oh, there's the sign. So it's just a little offset. I'll have to go back through and... make sure that I've invested in everyone. I know I've missed people in the Imperial City.
Does
City Swimmer.
Does anyone see City Swimmer? Is she gliding beneath the silver water? Is she creeping round a corner, hugging a wall, silent as a shadow in the dark?
I mean, I see
no,
you.
No, I am here.
Yeah,
I stand proud before you. City Swimmer, trainer of the prospective sneaker, the sly sliding unseen.
And quite a silver tongue you have, too, City Swimmer.
You too.
Should be a trainer of speechcraft. Where's the other beggar? Oh, here we go.
I'm only asking for an... Thank you.
Outspoken hit to him. Well, Akatosh is a good blessing. At least it is in Skyrim. I'm not sure what it is in the others. Or here, rather. So let's go do the Forlorn Watchman. He shows up at 8 p.m. Which means we have to go here at 8 p.m. Let's see. What time is it now? Oh, actually. Have we discovered this? Yeah. Let's go right there, and we should get there at just around 8 p.m. Be on time. It's a good thing I fucked around. Oh, has appeared at Nibbin Bay. Where are you? There you are. Oh, hey. Please? Please what? Okay, he ignores us. So, you gonna do your thing, buddy? Or am I just gonna stand here like an idiot? There we go. So yeah, we're gonna have to follow him for a while. It's interesting that it shows detect life on him, even though he's a ghost. I mean, ghosts are considered alive for whatever fucking reason. Also, I should equip a weapon of some sort. You know, before we get into any danger. Because it's definitely liable to happen. Something clicked behind me. I'm a little worried that it was like the power strip or something. Oh. It's just a mic crab. I should really charge my weapon. So, yeah, we're just gonna follow this guy for a little while. I may speed this up unless we get there soon, because I don't have a lot of commentary while just following a glowing person. Also, let me know something. It makes it a lot easier for me to play, just, you know, as a player, if I have Detect Life on. However, when we get into towns and we need to talk to people, I know it can be really distracting to see the glowing effects of Detect Life when we're talking to someone face-to-face. So please let me know if I should take off the ring for Detect Life whenever I get to towns or something like that. Or, you know, whenever I get into a speech situation. If it's too distracting, I'll just make sure that I take it off. Or just not wear anything that gives me Detect Life. I can do that too. I want it to be good for the viewers, you guys, more than for me. So, yeah, let me know in the comments down below whether or not I should keep Detect Life on. Obviously, it's really easy for me to follow him, because now, in addition to being a ghost, he's also a big, pink, glowing blob. So, yeah. I only wish that he moved a little faster, because he takes forever. Truthfully, I don't think you actually have to wait for him. You could go right to the place where he stops and continue on from there. However, I don't exactly remember the exact location, you know, offhand. I guess I can look it up and just go. But consider this like a little guide or something. Wow, dude. I believe we've crossed over to the other side of Nibbin Bay. Oh, no. We haven't. We're just here. Oh, I remember where he stops. We're not too far, actually. May as well just keep it going. Although, it's interesting that I've, like, discovered these, ruins and stuff already. I didn't realize I had. Oh, another imp. Ow. Oh, never mind. It didn't hurt. Get wrecked, imp. bitches ain't nothing. I actually can't remember if there's any combat involved in this quest, like, once he stops. I think maybe? I wonder. Well, I guess we're just moving on. Ooh. Is there something glowing up there for a second? No. I guess not. It's my eyes playing tricks on me. At least I finally got the animations for the sprites to calm down, and they're not bugged out. Apparently they can get overloaded or something like that, and their cache. Catch. Oh, oh, the okay then. In the mouth of the panther. And then he stands and looks this way. So if you continue exactly along the way that he is looking and pointing, you will find the mouth of the panther. What is the panther? The Panther River, of course. This may be a little too dark for you guys to see. Although I'm about to go into the water, so I don't know if it'll matter. I should maybe get a light spell or something like that. Or maybe I'll just won't be lazy and I'll equip a torch. Yeah, let's do that. Wow, do I have hidden stuff? Oh, Glarthir's notes. Or stolen stuff, not hidden stuff. I didn't realize I even had anything. There we go. It's not much of an improvement, but a little something for you guys. Because I know that this is dark. I may go in and brighten it. Maybe not. Depends on how much I care. Wait, am I going the right way or did I already pass it? Oh no, I'm going the right way, yeah. Unless that's it. Mouth of the Panther, there we go, yeah. I've already discovered it when I was looking for Nern Root. Anyways, the Mouth of the Panther is a ship. Yeah. Remember we saw this as we were looking for Nernroot? Yes. Let's investigate the wreck. Wait a minute. Something doesn't like us. Oh. Just a stupid mud crab. Well, let's go into the creepy fucking boat. Ah! Moonwraith! Okay, yep, there's combat. Oh, oh, this is not gonna be good. Too glimmery. Wait, am I getting hurt by the frost? Do I have my frost? Oh shit, I don't. What's better? Not the Ring of the Grey, that's for sure. Yeah. There we go. At least I'll be able to resist some of the attacks that they can cast. Ow. Is there another one in here? No. At least I hope not. You know, it's a good thing that your spells can cast a lot of light, because otherwise we wouldn't be able to see shit in here. This game really does get quite dark. Also, wow. Dial. Jeez. I really need to enchant a weapon so that I can do major damage. Wait, is there a third one in there? Take forever if there's a third. Okay. Sometimes you just have to stand here and be boring. Oh. Okay, apparently, I've got to kill one to get a quest update. I didn't know about that. Or maybe I've forgotten. Ah, stab attacks. Stab attacks used to be the default kill everything. Whoa. Guess he did not like me. Stab attacks used to be the default major damage thing in Morrowind, so I'm wondering if they are the same. Well, they don't seem to be doing much. Honestly, it's probably just better if I mash them. Jeez. Liberates take forever. I guess it's because I'm such a high level. I gotta wait. Oh, don't have enough magic at the cast again. Don't have enough stamina. Now I can cast it again. There we go. At least my heavy armor increased. Wow. I didn't expect that to get leveled up. It's gonna take a while for it to get to a master level. Hopefully this wraith won't die. I think I hear another gloom wraith. Or just wraith in general. That's not good. Well, okay, there we go. Yeah, I don't need his elven sword. Captain's cabin. Oh, wait. Oh, have you already seen me? Yep, you probably have. Yep. Another gloom wraith. Whoa. What? Did it break? Oh, no. That's not good. I can't repair it in combat, can I? Oh, I don't even have a repair hammer. Oh, that's not good at all. Well. Shitty marksman. Time to do some work. Although, honestly, punching might be better. Although, I don't know if... Don't know if that could, Oh, I'm silenced. Shit. I don't know if, You can hurt... Wraiths... with unarmed. I may have to check this out right now, because definitely need something. Although it seems like the bow is doing more damage than my sword did. Wow. It's kind of sad, actually. I really need to get a better weapon. This is just confirming it for me. At least this raises up my marksman skill. Oh, out of those arrows. So let's switch to ebony. Oh, wait. Oh, same damage. Interesting. I hope I get some of these arrows back. There we go. Just a glass longsword, that's it. And none of my arrows. Fantastic. Well, let's see what's in here. Oh, a chest. Potions of healing. Fantastic. Absolutely useless for me. Wow, and there's nothing else. Oh, goddammit. Wait, was that really everything in here? Log of the MMA. I'm not going to read this. I'm just going to go through. You can pause the video and read it yourself. Yeah. So there was a mutiny. People got dead. That's about it. So there's another... I believe there's another... way down... Yes. So, and let's see, if I don't find repair hammers here, I'm probably gonna go back to Bravil. Oh, I found one. Fuck me. I really wish I had the perk for repair hammers never breaking. Alright, let's see how far I can make it with this one. Oh, okay. Weapon restored. Okay, let's work on armor. Nope, okay. Didn't even get through. I'm really gonna need to go back and get repair hammers. So, I'm gonna do that real quick. Especially now that I've discovered the mouth of the river. So, it's obviously very easy for me to get back there. Oh, wait. Does Bravil even have somebody that I can buy repair hammers from? Does anyone in the Fighters Guild sell repair hammers?
We're looking
for... Oh, it's Porter. I don't want to talk to you yet.
Good day.
We're looking for...
Yeah, you're looking. You're training. Be seeing you. They offer a lot of training, but I don't... Afraid of trouble. Ooh, your shop?
I would glad...
Okay, then. Sure, why not?
Farewell.
All right, well, good to know. People in the guilds are considered shops. I guess once I'm in the guild, I can barter with her. For now, I can't. Glass, though. Shit.
Have you heard about that ghost of the old man that looks out into Nibbon Bay each night? They're calling him the Fallen.
Well, I can't do much else in here.
Goodbye.
I guess until I join the Fighters Guild, I can't really barter with them. Warlock's luck. Can't do anything there yet. Maybe the Archer's Paradox? It's interesting because they don't actually have a place for weapons and armor here. There's a magic shop and it's 8 a.m. Open up your goddamn shop. There we go. Alright.
Well,
do you?
I offer the finest goods and lowest prices in
all. Two. Whatever.
Tell your friend.
Let's see how far that gets me. Two. I may just have to go to the Imperial City. Ugh. The other one's gonna break. Wow. Yep.
Take care.
Yeah, let's just go to the Imperial City. Buy up all the repair hammers I need. The Market District really is perfect for this stuff. It's just unfortunate that the other cities are so ill-equipped for shops. Like, it almost seems like sometimes they were just like afterthoughts. Because, I mean, like, it's very clearly...
You know... Have a look at my ware.
Not right. Yes, I need repair hammers. I need all your repair hammers.
Come back and see.
I really want armor to level up already.
I hope I can help.
I need that perk from Master, where one repair hammer will last you forever. And you never need to buy another repair hammer or pick up another one again. You just have one in your inventory, and it fixes every fucking thing. Okay, just go through real quick. Mash the button. Actually, now that I have a whole bunch of stuff and I have the perk to repair things to 125, I may go through every item I own and repair it to 125. Because it's a very easy way getting your armor up. Alright, black water blade. Actually, can I recharge it? Wait, let's just absorb fatigue though. I don't suppose I have any. Yeah, I don't have any soul gems. That's fine. Alright, well. Let's go into sneak mode. And down into the next deck we go. And instantly Gloomwraith. How many, though? I don't really want to get into a fight with two of them. I can avoid it. Oh, there's another one, isn't there? Well, out. Fuck it. Oh, there's the Glimwraith dying. Yeah, I really needed to fix my blade. Jesus. Oh, okay. Let's not get bashed into the wall here. I'm really gonna need you to die. At least it's a good workout for my clicking finger. I'm really gonna love the fact that the other enemies we're fighting in this episode are all human. At least I think they all are. I don't think we're fighting anything else. Oh, need to heal up. Oh, please don't tell me there's another one back there. Come on. Get over here.
Get over here.
Oh, stamina ran out. I really should be paying more attention to that as well. Because stamina is pretty important if you don't want to have those embarrassing moments where you fall over. Unfortunately, the AI is very good about not running out of stamina when it doesn't want it. Anything worth a damn? Nope. I'm actually very glad that I went back and got repair hammers because, yeah, look at that. It's not a bad idea to do this after every combat now that I'm thinking about it. Good way to raise up armorer and make sure that I'm not, you know, wasting your time by fighting enemies for an hour. Ooh, a lockpick actually could come in handy. Alright, let's see, what else is here? I don't think there's another level to the ship, but I could be wrong. I mean, we're fighting boss level Gloomwraiths. Oh my god, there is another level. Fantastic. Which means even more Gloomwraiths, guys. That bread loaf, it can't be good. It can't be a good idea for anyone, let's be honest. Oh, you're different. Gable the Traitor. Well, you're definitely a Wraith. You're just a leveled Gloomwraith, aren't you? Ooh, it does a lot of damage, wow. What are you constantly draining from me? I'm not entirely sure. Intelligence? Willpower or something? It can't be a different spell. Or, it can't be much different from the spells that other things do. Small key. That was slightly easier than the others. Ooh, repair hammer. Those are becoming more and more useful as we go through. And wow, the leveled gold rewards are just paltry sums at this point. Yeah. Judging by how little damage he did to me and how quickly he died, kind of underleveled, I'm guessing. Yep. So, there he is. Let's set him free.
I knew one day someone with unyielding virtue would heed my words and speed my release. You risk much to perform such a selfless act.
Anything for
this
the cause.
This noble deed will not go unrewarded. Look upon the ground in this prison. There you will find a map to my gratitude. I thank you with all my heart. Farewell.
And for our troubles, somewhere in here, yep. That was kind of creepy, especially because I didn't see it. There's a location to his treasure, which is, we're at the mouth of the panther here, and it's across the way. Now, this really confuses me, because he would have had to have drawn that after they crashed. Which I find really weird. But let's not question it. Let's just go get our reward. Ugh, creepy fucking place. So I guess we didn't have to go into the cabin's captain's quarters at all. Alright, so, oh, cool. Did it actually update where we're supposed to go for the... Oh yeah, it did. Well, cool. Let's go get our treasure and, head back to Bravil. I was actually not expecting it to give us a compass marker. I think I may just have to detect life off because I like the frost ring way too much. I might dequel. Oh, another Nern root. Yeah, this river is also a good source of Nern root. Really, any body of water. Wow. Blood just gets smeared over everything. I'm guessing because the game doesn't quite understand what to do with the texture half the time. Mud crab slaughter. Oh, another Nern root. And continue on. I honestly can't remember if there's a unique reward for this or if it's just leveled loot. It might just be leveled loot, in which case I'm probably going to be pretty disappointed with what I get. Oop. Went into third person for a second there. It's in the water, I believe. Oop. Something doesn't... Oh, it's just another mud crab. Oh, good thing we're an Argonian. So we can swim right up to it. There it is. Yep, treasure chest concealed amongst the rocks. Is there anything amazing here? Not really. I mean, there's lots of nice things, especially if you're a lower level character. The problem is, like, none of this is really that amazing. Technically, the sword does more damage than what ours does, right? Because the backwater blade is 28. It says 23, but 20 points of shock damage, so 43, technically. It's definitely got a better enchantment than what we have. Oh, and it's ebony. So let's use that for a little while. And then a little thing up here. Oh, bandit. I was like, what doesn't like us? Wow. I have not heard that taunt before, but it's really annoying. Let's see how well this does. Oh, pretty well, actually. I may have to get myself some soul gems so that I can use this weapon better. And you're dead. Potion of healing. Okay, well, there's the Forlorn Watchman completed. Let's head back to Bravil. With new sword in hand. Okay. So, I'm gonna quickly repair. And then, let's do a more interesting quest. Because fighting is nice and all, but, you know, you gotta break it up with something else every now and then. I'll admit, like, the combat quests in this game just get old after a while because there's only so much you can do. But there are rather fun ones. Let's see. She's not even awake, is she? Well, guess we gotta wait until morning. Your friend's in danger and you wanna sleep? How could you? It's terrible of you. There you are.
Hello to you.
Hello to you. Ooh, your eyes are awesome.
Are you here about joining the Mage's Guild?
No, I'm here about something else.
Things in the guild have been different since Traven was named Archmage. They're more structured, but everyone seems tense.
Wait...
I take my duties as chapter.
Oh, you don't like me, do you?
For you, of course.
No, you do like me. How?
Please, I'm in desperate need of help, and I think you're the only one that I can turn to.
Something I can do for you?
Okay.
I don't suppose
you
could
help
me locate my friend Henantir, could you?
That was weird. Okay, then.
I miss him so. We were study mates at the Arcane University, and we've come to grow fond of each other over the years.
Oh.
He's always getting himself into jams with the careless ways he performs his experiments. And, well, I'm afraid he's done it again.
He's done it again, folks.
I'm going to
live with you
as you seem like you wish to help. Henantir isn't missing. On the contrary, I know exactly where he is. The problem is, he's trapped and there's no way I can free him.
Sounds like a personal problem. I'm not that soulless.
Well, Henantir's been warned that if he strays outside the guild rules one more time, he may be up for summary dismissal. The rules say that he isn't to practice dangerous experiments at his home. It must be done in the guild under the watchful eye of an associate.
And of course he's broken that rule.
Henantir's never been one for rules,
yep.
And so he's continued to perform his latest experiments in secret. If word gets out, he'll be dismissed.
Well, let's
great.
Just get the room.
Whatever
I'm
suits
not that
you
cold.
And gets
I...
me Henantir back suits
whatever.
Me just fine.
I'm kind of worried about the
when
person.
When you're ready
I mean,
to go
you
and
know,
see him, let me know.
Don't
but please,
leave people in weird
worry.
Places.
I'm
through a nightmare darkly, which incidentally takes its name after
she's an excellent healer.
Through a mirror darkly.
A
I believe that's the
I know that
novel that it's referencing.
Are you ready to...
Yeah, let's go to Henantir.
I see. Have you heard any word about the other provinces?
And of course
nothing
we have to
I'd
wait.
Like to
what is her sword? Huh. It's kind of weird seeing the Daedric short sword in a scabbard. Well, I guess it's not even a scabbard. It's just like a... Oh, excuse me. It's just some sort of weird holster. Well, okay then. Henantir's house, which was conveniently locked the entire time before this. Oh, unfortunately, everything's still steel. So, interesting glitch. If you do anything like attack her
as you
or
can see,
something,
Henantir's
or
right
attack,
here, and
I believe him as well, he will wake
world.
Up and do stuff like walk around, but will still technically be in the dream world, which is really weird.
I told him that trying to travel into one's own dreams is risky, but as usual, he didn't listen to me. Always has to do things his way.
Sounds like a douchebag.
Henantir constructed a magical device he called the Dream World Amulet. With this device, one can enter his own mind and experience dreams.
Yeah, I mean, this sounds like lucid
this
dreaming.
This is different. When you enter your dreams with the amulet, you're in full command of a dreamlike replica of yourself.
Yep, definitely just lucid dreaming.
All your thoughts, your skills, and your talents travel there with you. Think of it as exploring a new land, but a land within your own mind. Henantir created the amulet to see if he could use his dreams as a training ground to help better himself.
But...
I don't know all of the details, but the amulet is a conduit to get to that training ground.
Obviously
it's
something went wrong.
3 days, and he's been stuck in his dreams. I've watched him all that time, and he hasn't been up at all. The only way to save him is to put on the Dream World amulet and go to sleep. Only then can you hopefully find out what's happened in there.
Well,
I fear that
yeah,
anyone
why not you?
Who knows won't be
what
able
do I have
to
go
help
in?
Him in there. Since I'm in his memories, he may dismiss me as a figment of his dreams.
Oh, bullshit. You're just
the
afraid.
Only chance is for a total stranger to enter his dreams. When you're ready to do this, I'll give you the amulet. Only I know the secret way it can be removed from his neck.
By removing it from his neck? I'm just going to take a stab in the dark.
You'll have to be very careful in there. If Henantir intended it as a training ground, there's no telling what you may encounter.
Some really weird pauses in her dialogue.
My poor Henantir. I shudder to think what's happened to him in there.
Oh, did she already give me the amulet?
Don't take this sojourn lightly. The recesses of the mind can be the darkest place of all.
Just flail. But pretty sure I did not get the amulet from you.
Are you prepared?
Oh, you have to actually talk to her again? That's weird.
Please, use the extra bed here. If you sleep too far from Henantir, it may not work. I'll watch over you both to make sure you're safe. Oh my, I almost forgot.
What?
Henantir once told me that if he's killed in his dreams, anyone that's in there with him will die as well. So do be careful.
So don't kill Henantir.
Now is the time for sleep. How I wish I could go with you.
Man, talking about sleep's got me yawning. Sorry about that, guys. I want to point out kind of a plot weird plot hole in this. If the amulet makes you enter your own dreams, won't putting on the amulet and going to sleep just make me have my own lucid dream instead of joining Henantir? Think about that for a little while. Because it's kind of important. Anyways, we put on the Dream World amulet, which... it's a fancy looking thing. There we go. It's huge. Also, interestingly, why does she have a second Dream World amulet? So many questions left unanswered. Now, let's go to sleep.
My word, you startled me. Are you real?
Yep. No magic, no nothing. But defending myself. Yeah. And I'm naked. Well, this can't be good.
I've lost my way. This place looks so familiar, but I can't remember how I got here. Can you help me?
Sure, why not?
This place is so strange. Dream world, you say? It's more like a nightmare. I don't like this place at all. I feel like I shouldn't be here. There must be an exit around here somewhere. I'd explore this place, but I'm afraid I just don't have the courage to do so.
You fucking wimp.
How could I be so careless? What's the matter with me? I know I've lost something. Yes, that's it. I've lost many things in this strange place. Would you please help me?
Man, that's... oh, God, that's super fucking creepy. It's fucking, like, dead eyes. There's, like... is there, like, a ghost or something in this place?
We must get out of this place.
It's really unsettling. Anyways, yeah. So are his eyes. Oh, and there's this weird mist that suddenly appeared. Anyways, so you've got to go through and complete these tests in order to help him regain parts of his mind. Now, in here, there's clothing. We don't need the scales. Nothing you actually take in here. I don't want to equip it. How do I drop? There we go. Shift. But there's nothing of use in here. There is a bed if you want to save your progress and level up and everything, because you can level up here. Which is interesting, but ultimately useless. Anyways, I'm just going to go through and let's start with the test of perception. So, yeah. There's a little, like, casks before each one that give you something to go off of. So, this one gave us a torch. And it is the test of... perceive. Now, obviously, there's the end. But there's no path there, so we have to travel carefully. Uh-huh. Traps. Yep. This entire section is just traps. Avoid the traps. Now, we have a stupidly high acrobatics, so for us, that's literally just a jump through everything. Except for here. Which I believe we can still get fucked up by it. Jump over that. Pressure plates. Avoid those. Yeah. High acrobatics will destroy anything that the tests put against us. And we have the element of perception. So it's something that Henantir lost.
Have you found an egg?
Unfortunately, you can't get more from him. You have to complete all of the tests before anything will happen. I'm tempted to go ahead and do the strength one now. It's courage. Resolve. Heal yourself, which just has potions. This can actually get pretty difficult because you don't have any of your equipment. That's why the heal yourself stuff is there. Let's see. Actually, let's do the other one up here because I know how to do the patience. Mysterious scroll. What does the scroll say? Nothing. Well, that's strange. But if you pay attention to it, there are patterns here. Mainly. There. There. And this one is pretty elaborate. I believe it's these. Yeah, there's a repeating symbol in each one. They basically show you where you need to go to get past these. These are instant kills. They will fuck you up, regardless of your level, and regardless of how good you are at the game. So you can go through, and the reason why it's called the Test of Patience is because they expect you to go through and, you know, check each one. But, high acrobatics. Ooh! Interesting! That was not there before. Huh. When I played this on the Xbox, you could just jump over it. But it seems like they've put an invisible wall up. Huh. I'm, like, actually surprised. Well, then. In that case, gonna have to do this the actual hard way. Alright, so it looks like it starts here, goes there, and one over once we get to the third. Now, if I recall correctly, it's mirrored. So it should be through here. But I'm gonna do a quick save. Okay, apparently it's not mirrored. Alright, well, now I know. Really? Invisible walls? Really, game? Alright, so it's not mirrored. Which means that it's this one? So it's 1, 2, 3. And up two. So it's 1, 2, 3. Up two. And then we could just jump across. Huh. Maybe we can jump across, and only that first one was, had the weird-ass thing. Not sure. Let's see. So it looks like we're safe there. So I'm curious. Interesting. I can't actually do that. Huh. They totally did put in invisible walls. Well, I can't cheat through it. So. I believe here, 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 here? Although, now I can jump through. Huh. So, you only need to make it through a little bit of it. Then you get the element of patience.
We must get out of...
I can't sleep while you're in a dream. Interesting. Oh, and you can't regain health. Can we wait in a dream? Yep. And because we wait, get all of our health back. Easy way to do that. Test of courage. What's this? Because I can't remember. Oh, yeah. There's potions of water breathing here. Ultimately, this test is completely useless for us because we are Argonian. I mean, the real test of courage here would have been if they put the frickin' giant slaughterfish in here randomly. That would have scared the shit out of me. But, alas, you don't actually have to worry. If you're an Argonian...
We must get out of this place.
And then the last one. Wow, everything's getting a lot darker. Go into the test of Well, we would go into the test of resolve if the game hadn't crashed. Alright, there we go. Now into the test of resolve. Goddamn game. So I believe... Oh, yeah, it gives us leveled stuff. We are much better with heavy armor, yeah. Yes, we are. Definitely better with blade. Although the war axe does, disintegrate weapon. It's a dagger, though. That's why it does so little damage. Might as well take both. Can take that. Let's take everything, screw it. Definitely want to equip all the Daedric stuff. And, let's use this and see if we can't break the weapon. Doesn't this look familiar? The arena? Well, sort of. Except, with minotaurs. Now, interestingly, I've never actually tried using this because... Oh yeah, it totally just broke his weapon. Well, it doesn't have enough charge anymore. Wow. Get wrecked. Just spam the lightning staff. You don't actually get to keep any of this stuff. So, it's a fun little distraction. You can try out some new toys if you don't usually use staves. Well, there's the staff run out. And switch to the war axe. It's nice that the game actually takes into account what your good and leveled with, and your actual level, because it will create enemies that are leveled to you. Like the, I believe these are Minotaur Warlords or something like that. I can't remember the actual classification. But, yep, just kill them. You can take their stuff if you want. There's no real difference. But, then we go up here. And get the element of resolve. And with all four elements, we can talk to Henry.
I feel as though I'll be trapped here forever. And I don't even know why.
Dream world.
But how? What you say must be the truth. I feel strange. I can see now what you were saying was no story at all, but the truth. And I'm a fool. I had no idea that the amulet could hold such power over me. I set out to create a way to conquer my failings. But it seems the tables had turned, and they conquered me. I don't know how you did it, but I thank you. Now, we must wake from this dream and take our places in the real world again. Farewell.
Well, there we go.
It's good to see you real world.
You're I'm much less creepy in real life.
Me from my nightmare. I suppose thanks are only a small token of my appreciation. Allow me to reward you for your bravery. I'm afraid I don't have much in the way of coin.
Never mind.
But allow me to present you with something that may help in your travels.
A sword? Oh. Flame shield scroll. That's it. That's the only thing.
Farewell, friend.
You. Give me the staff on your fucking back. Ass hat. And, I don't believe she gives us anything.
Now that Henantir has returned, things are as they should be.
Yep, she doesn't give us anything either. Oh, but we are naked. Wait. Did she strip us while we were sleeping? I suddenly don't feel all that well. Jesus. Let's just move on. I don't want to talk about it. Creepy people. Anyways, let's move on with the last quest here in Bravil. Caught in the hunt. We need to go talk to that person. Lonely Suitor Lodge. Which, let's face it, if your husband is going to a place called the Lonely Suitor Lodge, which is very obviously a front for like a brothel, you probably have other issues going on with your life. Yeah, let's talk to you.
None of your damn business. I'd tell you if I liked you, and I don't.
Really?
Go ahead.
Well, I'm definitely not bribing this guy. All right.
Not bad. I don't talk. I doubt it.
Yeah, that's a little bit better. But probably need to get him to...
Sure, that's cute. Yeah, I accept. Don't waste your All right.
73 enough?
Maybe I know him.
Yeah,
maybe
there we
I
go.
Don't. But since you're so interested, I know something that could jar my memory.
Yeah, what is
I
that?
I just learned that a family heirloom, the Axe of Dragol, which one of my stupid relatives lost, is located on Fort Grief Island in Nibbin Bay. My informant tell me it's hidden in the main keep at the center. Don't know what's guarding it, but I'm sure you can handle it.
Well, this is obviously a setup.
Bring it back to me,
I mean, not a
I'll
setup.
Tell you exactly
in
where
perfectly
Alaron
legitimate
is.
Business.
Then Alaron may not be coming home from his journey for a very long time. Like, permanently. Whenever you're ready, and it better be soon, I'll have a boat waiting for you to get to Fort Grief Island.
You're a dick.
Yeah, it's a battle axe with the word Dragol carved into the haft. Huge. You can't miss it. I ain't gonna draw you a picture.
Well,
don't you have something to find?
Let's go to the boat.
Are you ready?
Do we just talk to him? Yeah. Yeah, I'm ready.
Fine.
Is that so? Making you swim.
Well, let's go to the boat. Next to the magic shop? Oh, I guess it is a magic shop, isn't it? Well, here we go. Curtin's boat. Activate it, and you get transported. It's interesting that they did it this way, but I understand why. Because you can technically swim here, and there's nothing preventing you from getting on the island. However, there's an issue if you don't take the boat. In which case, the game will, positively freak the fuck out. Am I supposed to go around a different way or something? It's kind of weird. Or is the gate supposed to be open? And it's not? I totally didn't see the turn handle. Now, you can see him there. I'm pretty sure he's noticed the gate opened. He's an idiot. Oh. Wonder if... Yep, and there we go. The gate closes.
Oh, no.
Well... Ooh, red silk robes, huh? I'll take those. Sacks food, skeletons. So obviously, people have been lured into this before. Ooh, rusty iron short sword. Huh. I actually don't know if I have that, so go ahead and take that. Fine iron longsword, which I have. Yeah, Okay.
It appears as though Curdan has tricked another poor soul with his axe story.
Well, we you weren't really tricked, yet, but...
There never was any axe of Dragol. It was just a ruse to lure you out here. I fell for the same trick. In my case, he told me if I retrieved the axe, he'd erase my debt. I was such an idiot to believe him. You're now the prey in Curdan's insane hunt, just like I am. And here we'll most likely die.
Well, the difference is I'm heavily armed and a master of quite a few different techniques. But tell me more about the hunt.
Curdan doesn't make most of his money being a simple usurer. He also invented what he calls the hunter's run. People pay him a great deal of money to hunt and kill living human prey. No questions asked, and he takes care of the bodies. He uses the dungeons under Fort Grief as the hunting grounds. I was placed here because he knew someone would go looking for me. I'm sorry you got mixed up in all of this. I hope you can fight. It's our only chance of escaping alive. Don't bother. The door to this place is now locked. The only way to get out is by descending into the hunter's run and killing the hunters. One of them will have the key to the door. That's Curdan's rules. It's the only way we can win. I wish I could help more, but I can't fight. I've never held a weapon before in my life. Please, get us out of here.
Well, looks like we don't really have a choice. We have to go through and kill everyone. Yay. I don't know why I'm going into sneak, to be honest. I probably shouldn't. Gate needs a key. Well, hey. Detect life comes in handy here. I don't know if I can even possibly sneak through here. Wow. Took out half your health. Well, this is going to be easy. First hunter's run key. What was your weapon? Wait. I saw it. Oh. No, I saw it just a second ago. Oh, okay. Didric short sword. Here's the thing. I don't know why Curdan didn't, like, tell me to come without arms and armor. I mean, like, I can fuck everybody up that he sends against us. He should have seen, like, the dude in full Daedric armor and been like, oh, yeah, maybe we shouldn't, send that guy to the island. He'll probably kill everybody we have there. Like, what were you thinking, man? Well, obviously you weren't thinking, but it's besides the point, really. Ooh. Oh, goddammit. Are there ghosts in here? What is that? Or is that just a rat? Okay. I was about to say, I'm like, Christ. I really can't deal with ghosts right now. They take way too long to kill. I've always wondered if the game actually multiplies the damage from your, That's never a good... Ow. Wow. I actually got knocked in. Well, I feel like an idiot. Oh yeah, there's a nerd root in here. Did not need that bone, but I picked it up anyway. I feel like I keep hearing a ghost, even if there isn't one. Did I snap a... What? I don't think I hit a tripwire. Is there anything back here? I'm not entirely sure. I don't really care. What the heck am I triggering? I don't see a pressure plate. Oh, whatever. Oh yeah, that tripwire activates gas. Which, interestingly, can kill the dude up here. And that's the second one down. Level just reward, I think. Although there isn't much in it. And on to the next one. I believe there's two more. Oh, only one more? Really? Could have sworn there was another one. Huh. Let's switch to the sword for the rat. Don't want to use up the charges on my blade because I don't think I have any, Oh, I have one soul gem, which has no actual charge. Welp. So much for that idea. Oh, more gas. And more arrow traps without an actual trigger. At least, like, I'm telling you, there is no trigger for them. No tripwire, no nothing. I don't know what's going on there. Oh, can you actually sleep? Huh, you totally can. Interesting. And, third guy should be in here? Yeah, there he is. Imperial Hunter. Or, I guess it's not Imperial Hunter, it's just whatever they are. Oh. I wonder.
What do you think you're doing?
Okay. Ooh, did he disarm me? Oh, he totally did. Where is it? There it is. You ain't getting rid of my weapons like that. Ass. Kind of wish I could have got the sneak attack on him, though. But I wanted to see if I could steal the key. Although, I guess it might be scripted so that you can't. Or maybe you can, I don't know. This game's sort of lenient about letting you actually use your skills that, you want. Oh, there we go. Now we switch to the other sword. This has got a better base attack. Since we don't have any more charge. It's not how I usually play this game. Nah, usually I would enchant a weapon with Soul Trap and at least one other effect. Because that way it traps a soul every time you kill someone. And also does lots of damage. Of course, you get less uses because it's soul trapped, but what are you going to do? I guess you could enchant a bow with soul trap, which is what a lot of people end up doing. And by having that bow enchanted, yep, I got the last key. By having the bow enchanted, you basically hit them with the bow first and then initiate combat, kill them, and hopefully you will kill them quick enough that the soul trap is still enacted. Usually by having it a really long duration. Now, I'm actually kind of curious. No, I can't sneak attack the next guy. That's right. Well, that's unfortunate. There's a chest. And out here. I don't know, can I? Oh. Huh. Interesting. Oh, and then I guess we head all the way back up. Oh, right, there was that locked door. Which I think I go this way? Yep, and follow the trail of dead bodies. We can open this? Huh. I wonder what that opens. Weird. So we come out here, and he dies. Well, that's unfortunate. But there's him. Where's his friend? Door's still locked. He does have a bodyguard. A very heavily armed bodyguard. Oh, he is scripted to come talk to us, isn't he?
That's annoying. That you killed all my clients. Doesn't matter. More will come along with their purses fat with gold and hearts lusting for blood.
You're an ass.
Bad about Alarum. Didn't need him anymore now that you're here. At least now he's free of his debt. Do you really think I could afford to let you leave here? The key you found is a fake. No prey has ever left this island alive.
Well,
and I aim to keep it that way. You were right about one thing, though. This is my game, and I'm changing the rules.
Instant detect. And I'm guessing the other guy just spawns in randomly? Yep, there he is. He has an enchanted, hammer. Well, let's kill this dude first. Human enemies are so much weaker compared to the, gloom wraiths. What does he have? Does he have a unique hammer? I can't remember. It looks like it's just Daedric, but... might be unique. Well, I know. Jeez. Alright, get up. Oh, okay, he's dead. Oh, God. Stop hitting me with arrows. Just get up. Fucking marksmen. And their goddamn perks. Aw, oh, really? Knew I should have stopped by. Ooh. There was a shark. He has three real keys? Interesting. I guess for each of the... Wait, I thought you had a different person with you. I thought it was the Argonian. You'll make it fine. Interesting. Huh, I wonder who the heavily armed Argonian was in the, town then. Well, now you're dead. Congratulations. Well, looks like I gotta make some room. Well, hopefully the repair hammers will break or not. I get really lucky with them now, all of a sudden. Yep, apparently so. Alright, what can I drop? Probably eat all these ingredients. No, I didn't mean to eat a nerd. Fuck. God damn it. Wow, I've got a lot of potions. Could drop some of them. As much as I really want the red silk stuff, I should probably drop them. Well, let's find out how over-encumbered I'm going to be. By three. Oh, well, maybe I can actually get away with something else. Yeah, I actually do have a rusty iron short sword, so I can drop that. Anyways, the way to open up this place is to go back inside, open this gate, and turn the handle. And then you go back out. We don't need to pick up anything from Alarum. Oh, we can pick up the house key. And through the door. And I believe we can just take the boat back, right? Yep. And we sail into Bravil. Bravely, bravely sail. Well, let's go tell the poor widow the news that her husband is an idiot. and died. I guess we should probably not mention the idiot part if he died. Might give off bad taste in the mouth or something like that.
Something's wrong, I can tell. What's happened to Alaron?
Yep,
he did. When I saw the grave look on your face, I knew something had happened to him. And what of that fetcher, Curtain?
Also dead.
Then Alaron's death has been avenged. I told him that the gambling would lead to this, that foolish man, but he never listened. Before you go, I have this for you. Alaron told me that if he ever got in trouble, this could be used to bail him out of jail.
Ooh, is it money?
He'll not be needing it any longer. And I want you to have it. I'll not take no for an answer. I know you did all you could. And for that, I thank you. Now please, go in peace. I wish to be alone.
Biography of the Wolf Queen? What? Give me a book? God damn it. I believe that it's actually a skill book. So, you can read this and... yeah. Ooh, fearful gaze tone. No. I don't remember if I've been using the tomes. Or if I've just been keeping them. Oh yeah, these are for something interesting later. The drain self spells. But... Yeah, it doesn't look like I've been using the tomes. Okay, so I'll keep those for later. But yeah, that's basically everything we can do in Bravil, except for buying a house. I'm going to hold off on that until the next episode, because it's a really quick thing, and this episode is already getting kind of long. Anyways, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time when... Let's go finish out Leowyn then. That sound good? Unless you guys like really, really want something else specific, in which case just leave it in the comments and I will get to that instead. Anyways, thanks for watching and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.